Okay, so what we did in the past is just using the what we call the first derivative test, or call the first order conditions. The logic is that suppose f is continuous, while c is the critical point. Critical point means that the first order condition you differentiate with respect to the variable ones, you will get it equal to zero, or it does not exist. Then here are the three of the properties of the first derivative test, or these three are the results. Okay, so first, if the f prime, you differentiate the function with respect to x once, it is changed from negative to positive. That means it decreases before the value of c, while it increase later. Then we say at the c, f has the local minimum. And if it's changed from positive to negative, we call this at the point C, that is the local maximum. And if there are no change in the sign, then there's neither the local maximum nor minimum. So for example, if you are given these equations, how to find the maximum point or minimum point using the first order conditions? First, you have to find that you differentiate it with respect to x ones. This becomes 12x cubed minus 12x squared minus 12x plus 12 equal to 0. Okay, you set it equal to 0. Then you can find all the critical points. Then you can simplify it as 12 times x plus 1 times x minus 1 squared. Okay. Then you can see that the critical points would be x equal to negative 1 and x equal to 1. Then to see whether this is the maximum or minimum, you can draw the sketch the functions like what we have done in the previous pages. Or we can rely on further the derivative test to see whether this is maximum or minimum. So here comes to the concept of the second order conditions. And this should be the last topics for the ECUF major selection interview math preparations. So what is the second order conditions? Before we talk about the second order conditions, let's talk about how this represents the second order. What is the meaning of second order? So actually the second order, that means you differentiate the function twice. Okay, so if you find that the double prime, so you differentiate it twice and you find this is positive, that means the function is concave up. Concave up means that it is the slope is keep on increasing. This can be like this, or this can be like this. Both you can see the slope become greater and greater. Okay, and if f double prime is less than 0, this means the function is concave down. Concave down means that the slope is decreasing, either like this or like this. Okay, the slope becomes steeper and steeper. And if f double prime change the sign, this means that this is the inflection point. Inflection point means it decreases, it is increasing, and we have a flat. Then it increases again. Okay, so this is the so-called inflection point. Therefore, to see whether this is maximum or minimum, you can rely on the second order conditions. The second order condition is defined as, first, you locate a critical point. Second, you differentiate it twice to see whether this is positive or negative. If this is positive, that means it will increase later. Therefore, the function has a local minimum at that point. If the second order condition is negative, that means this will decrease after the point C, then f has a local maximum at point C. Then if the second order condition is equal to 0, then we cannot conclude anything. It may be positive, it may be local maximum or local minimum. Okay, so let's keep on doing our previous examples. So what we have done is that f prime x is 12 times x plus 1 times x minus 1 squared. And the critical point is negative 1 and positive 1. So to see whether these two points are the maximum or minimum, you can differentiate it twice. So what you will get is 36x squared minus 24x minus 12. Okay, then if you substitute negative 1, this critical point, into the double prime function, what you will get is, okay, you replace x to be negative 1. And this is equal to 48, which is greater than 0. That means here is the local minimum. The function has the local minimum at f at x equal to negative 1. And we check the second critical point. We find that this is equal to 0. That means we don't know whether this is maximum or minimum. As a result, you have to draw this to see whether this is maximum or minimum. Check the first order condition before the 1 and after the 1 to see whether this is the maximum, minimum, or inflection point. So this is the review of mathematics. So I think this is sufficient, or at least this is sufficient for the preparation for the math test. Of course, you should grab your math textbooks to do lots of exercise before you go to the interviews. So good luck. I hope I can see you in the next semester.